Thanks a bunch.
I'm on it.
Let's get to it. Stay focused.
Ready and willing. What's next?
I stand ready. I think not.
I call that a win. Who, me?
Ready anytime.
Who, me?
I got this.
I did it! I did!
Leave it to me. Takes care of that.
Who knew?
You're relentless. I put in some work.
Thank you.
Never underestimate an outsider.
You're really tough.
That's the golden deer for you.
Nice try. Pure grit. How do you like that? That's all there is to know.
Huh? It worked out.
Celebrate later.
Sorry.
I call that a win. I'm aiming high. They say experience beats growth.
Magnificent.
Who knew?
Did the trick. I'm all sweaty.
Guess I'm...
You really...
So, I was right. You're too kind. Now I'm feeling a bit shy. Thank you for teaching me. Professor, let's do this again.
Professor.
I wonder why. Why does Lady Rhea give you special treatment? You're not particularly strong or good-looking. You seem exceedingly unremarkable. Not that I doubt you were a skilled mercenary. Shamir came from the same background, but she doesn't get nearly as much of Lady Rhea's attention. Besides, it'd be one thing if you got brought on as a knight, but a professorship, unprecedented. I just don't get it. I'm flummoxed as to why she holds you in such high esteem. And it's not like just anyone can wield the Sword of the Creator. It's a legendary relic, right? And it was casually handed over to you. It's unbelievable. Maybe it's because you're related to Geralt. He was a leader of the Knights of Saros, and probably the finest mercenary in all Fodlan. By the time I joined, he was gone. So I don't know him too well, but he's strong, right? Oh, come on. There can't be a soul in Fodlan who hasn't heard tales of the Bladebreaker. Maybe that's it. Geralt used his influence to help you. But Lady Rhea wouldn't give you favorable treatment because of that. No, definitely not. There must be something more to you. Okay, that settles it. I'm going to watch from afar, figure out what Lady Rhea could possibly see in you. Whatever it is, maybe I can copy it so that she'll take a shine to me as well. And if I discover that your intentions are malicious, I'll cut you down with relish.
Great timing, Professor. I was just going to come find you. Are you busy? I have a question about formations. I don't understand them at all. Are the speed of battle and the terrain connected somehow? There's too much to memorize. I don't? Then what do I have to know? I think I understand the basics. To start, you just... Ah, okay. I think I've got it. Thanks for the help, Professor. Brains and brawn. You've really got it all. With your help, I should have no trouble becoming a proper knight. Huh? Didn't I tell you? My parents were merchants of the Alliance. They died in an accident. That's why it's up to me to look after my little sis. I'm not great with bookkeeping, so I don't think I'd make a good merchant. I talked to Grandpa, and he suggested I become a knight. So I sold all our valuables and used the money to pay my way into the academy. My sis won't survive if I get kicked out, so I can't give up now. I might have tried being a mercenary if I didn't have my little sis to look after. I probably shouldn't say this, but being a mercenary does sound like an easier life. Mercenaries have no responsibilities. And no one else to worry about. But someone's gotta take care of my little sis. So that's out of the question. Serving as a knight in a noble house is more secure. And you don't have to worry about dying unless there's a war. My sis has been through so much. I don't want her to have to worry about me. Hey, do you have any siblings, Professor? Then you probably think I'm missing out on my freedom having to support her, huh? But working hard for my sister isn't too bad. Call it a burden, call it a challenge. If it makes my sister happy, I'm happy too. You should ask your father to have some more kids. Anyway, that's why I've got to become a proper knight.
Thanks.
That wasn't so bad.
I feel like I get it now.
Thank you so much.